Biocon's fourth quarter revenue growth was above expectations. The company clocked a growth rate of 17%, led primarily by its contract research division, Syngene. Ekta Batra and Nisha Poddar report on the growth triggers for Biocon.
Bangalore-based Biocon has beaten street expectations in the fourth quarter. Syngene, the company's research division, which listed in August 2015, delivered another strong quarter, clocking over 30% year-on-year growth with margins at 30%. Kiran Mazumdar Shaw is confident of continuing this momentum.
Syngene has had a very strong run thus far because I think all its basic strategic growth drivers are really driving good business. And as you know, Syngene has been investing in some of its anchor client business very robustly, and I think this is really panning out very well for Syngene. The BMS business continues to drive good growth, followed by Baxter, Abbott and Amgen. So I think they are getting good traction on this kind of large business opportunities.
Biocon recorded highest ever R&D spend in a quarter with a jump of 78% YOY to 100 crore rupees. Shaw says with this investment, R&D spends have peaked for now.
Quarter spend has been the highest to date. We've spent 100 crores at a net level and 152 crores at a gross level. And, you know, this almost reflects between 15 to 23% of biopharma revenues, which is a very significant spend in R&D. We expect this is sort of a, you know, has hit the top of the kind of spend rate that we anticipate. So I don't think you will see a much higher spend in R&D rates going forward.
The Biocon stock has run up ever since the company announced the approval of its biosimilar insulin drug, glargine, in the Japanese markets. In fact, gaining 18% in April itself. The street is optimistic of the company making inroads into other markets such as South Africa, Turkey and Russia, and submit filings for the US and Europe as well. In fact, Kiran Mazumdar Shaw is betting on both glargine as well as Biocon's oral insulin drug, IN-105.
Japanese approval means that we can actually start marketing this product this fiscal, and our partners Fujifilm Pharma have indicated that this should happen in the first half of this fiscal. So we will see our product in the Japanese market this fiscal, which is a great milestone for us. This also opens up many, many doors for us. Oral insulin is a program that we are going to now develop and take to the next phase of development. That trial should start very soon. And we will be then looking at oral insulin as an, possibly an approvable product in the next 2 to 3 years.
And while expanding the company's diabetes portfolio is a big trigger, the company is confident of maintaining the growth momentum. With Ekta Batra in Mumbai, this is Nisha Poddar.